Good day, fellow investors. Last week we launched the stock market contest, which stocks should we follow on this channel, and I'm very, very excited about the results. There were more than 158 individual entries, which shows how diversified is the investors' base. Everybody sees different value in different stocks. Therefore, every stock is giving some value to some investors. But let's cut to the chase and see the list. The leader was JD, Micron, Facebook, Applied Materials, Tesla, Newell, Coty, Bayer, Ego, then Baba, Disney, IQE, McKesson, Uranium, Microsoft, Visa, IBM, Google, and Infosystems. So these are the top 20 stocks, but there have been a massive selection of different stocks, from Swedish hotels to Australian miners to, I don't know, biotech companies, shady Chinese companies, whatever. So I have really seen a lot of that. And when we do the coverage of the top 10 stocks that I think will give a lot of value to you as an investor, especially in the long term, because there are some patterns, behavioral patterns there that we'll discuss just in a moment. But I'll also dig more into all the other stocks, especially the individuals, high potential stocks that, okay, there might be some value at some point in time. I want to have a model on that Swedish hotel stock out there because that's something interesting. So as always, you can expect a lot of stock analysis, but we'll start with the top 10. And let me show you a pattern that I have seen, and that might make you think, give you food for thought for your investment approach. As this is the most required, as those are the most required stocks on this YouTube channel, there is something to learn, I think, for the most of us there. Most required stock is JD.com, down 32%, 33% over the year. Micron Technology is up over the year, huge run up from 10 in 2016, but down also 30% from its 52-week high, definitely. Facebook down 8%, which is big for down over the year, 8%, also much more down from the top reached just a few months ago. Applied Materials also down hugely year to date. And also look at, again, a stock that spiked from 2015. Nobody looked at Applied Materials in 2015, 2016, Micron, 2015-16. Facebook was also cheap, below 100. Tesla also significantly down in the last year. Newell Brands, 3-year performance, minus 50%. Coty down 56% over the last 3 years, 40% year to date. Bayer down 33%. Eldorado 73% down. And just one in the top 10, Salesforce, that's up over 3 years and 54% up year to date. So one exception that makes the rule. So the first thing to learn here is, are we making decision on the base of what the stock market is saying about the stock? Answer this question or in the comments below. Who was looking at Micron in 2016 when it was at 10? I remember it so clearly. On the Croatian stock market board, one guy was saying buy Micron, buy Micron, buy Micron at 10. I checked Micron then, it was not fitting well my portfolio, or I was chasing some other things, did pretty well at that moment in time in Brazil with Nevsun with the first jump up. So I simply did something else, but Micron did extremely well in the last few years. But there is a big difference between buying it at 10 and looking at it really when nobody wants to look at it, or buying it now when it ran up to above 60, so 600%, 500% there, and now that it fell 30%, you might hope that it will go up to 60, but preventing yourself that it will go up to 10, that everybody already forget that it was just on 10 a few years ago. So think about how much is your investing behavior influenced by actual value, actual understanding, and that's something I really hope to give you the value back with. When we analyze those stocks, next stock that we'll analyze on this channel will be JD, so please hit that notification bell and subscribe if you haven't, and then we'll go through the top 10, perhaps even through the top 20 required stocks, because there is so much importance into this. Are we investing in the business, or are we investing in something just because the stock price dropped? Because it's very important to understand how are we influenced. We are humans, we have our patterns, and we cannot avoid those patterns. But if we understand those patterns, we can at least try to limit the pain, the mistakes we make. So it will be very interesting for me to show you my models on the top 10 related stocks. Of those stocks, we will cover some, because I think there is so much educational value in covering those stocks, but we'll pick we'll pick what stock to cover when we finish the top 10 analysis. And I will also add in the most interesting stock from the whole big list of stocks that I have. I will add them into here and there and videos, where there will be again a big learning experience by digging into the things that are not so obvious to everybody, and perhaps finding the next micron at 10 there where nobody is looking for. That's something that great investors do. They buy when there is nobody looking at, and therefore there is value. So we'll see how much value is in the top 10, and then we'll compare it to other stocks that might give you much more value in the long term. And just to add something so funny, another stock that exploded over last week was NIO, the Chinese Tesla competitor. And I know if I would have made the previous video this weekend, then NIO would probably be the top stock to watch. But why? Because it doubled over 1 day. 2 days, it went from 6 to what, 12. So that's extremely interesting to watch how we look for the market to tell us something about investing. If you want to invest in stocks like NIO, then you are an IPO investor, then you in detail analyze every IPO, and then you're ready, okay, if this hits that price I invest after IPO drop, then you follow that closely. Now everybody is crazy about NIO, everywhere I look I hear NIO. Just why? Because it doubled in 1 day. Again, a lot to learn here. Investing is about value, about the long term. Chasing these stock market moves means that you will burn out in the next stock market crash, because you will not be able to follow then. And all of those that chase these stock market moves, hot stocks, canopy growth, la la la, I guarantee you that 95% of you will not be investing in the next stock market crash, when it will be the most important time in your life to invest. So this is my message. Really think about, is this sustainable for me over the long term? Adjust your investing strategy so that you can invest over the next 20, 30, 40, 50 years, so that you can really gain something from investing. Thank you for watching. Looking forward to your comments. Thank you so much for the value adding that you did with this video. And I'll see you in the next video about JD.